Hello friends, a warm welcome to our program which we have titled as It's No Ordinary Child. May we as a family wish you all a very wonderful Christmas. Christmas is a time of family get-togethers, good fun, good food, but beyond all that is a celebration of the birth of our Savior Lord Jesus Christ. The first song that we're going to do says Mary's boy child Jesus Christ was born on Christmas Day. One of the lines I'd like to highlight is, man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. What does it mean? Listen on to this whole program and you will know. Pamparam, 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 pamparam. Long time ago in Bethlehem, so the Holy Bible says, Mary's boy child, Jesus Christ, was born on Christmas Day. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a new king's born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
While shepherds watch their flocks by night, they see a bright new shining star. They hear a choir sing a song, the music seems to come from afar. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a new king's born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day.
Now Joseph and his wife Mary came to Bethlehem that night. They found no place to lay the child, not a single room was inside.
Hark now, hear the angels sing, a new king's born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. By and by, a little nook in a stable all forlorn. Little boy was born. Hark now, hear the angels sing, a new king's born today. And man will live forevermore because of Christmas Day. Trumpets sound and angels sing, listen to what they say. And man will live forevermore of Christmas Day. Bum-ba-dum, 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 bum-ba-dum.
I hope you enjoyed the first song and you would have also sung along with us because it's a very familiar, popular song. The next song is a very famous carol, a song that is a popular favorite to many people. O Holy Night. The name of Jesus evokes worship. When the wise men came to see Jesus, they worshipped him. The shepherds, when they came to see Jesus, they worshipped him. When he rose again from the dead, there was a man who refused to believe that he rose again from the dead. But when he encountered him, he couldn't but worship him. Those who know him will worship him. Worship the Lord with us through this song and sing along if you know this song. O Holy Night.
O Holy Night, the stars are brightly shining. It is the night of the dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt his worth. A thrill of hope, a weary world rejoiced. and his gospel was peace. Chains shall he break, for the slave is a brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy in grateful chorus raise we, let all within us praise his holy name.
This festival season, let's remember, we are the reason that Jesus came down. He found each one of us so precious and valuable that he gave himself. That's the best gift that any of us could ever have. You see, by the way a person gives you a gift, you'll know how much valued you are. When God gave himself as a gift to us, he was just telling us that you are so valuable and precious to me. We have different reasons to celebrate Christmas, but blessed are we if we remember the real reason behind our celebration is the Lord Jesus, who came to give his life, who died and rose again from the dead, who has the power to transform the lives of those who come to him. He lives. Listen to the song, "We Are the Reason That He Gave His Life."
As little children, we would dream of Christmas morn, of all the gifts and toys we knew we'd find. But we never realized a baby born one blessed night gave us the greatest gift of our lives. As the years went by, we learned more about gifts, the giving of ourselves and what that means. On a dark and cloudy day, a man hung crying in the rain because of love, because of love. Suffered and died to a world that was lost.
For many, Christmas might not be a good news at all, not be a time of celebration at all. Probably you've gone through hurts, you've gone through pain which you can't share to others. But as the song reminds you, He's Emmanuel. God is with us. If you reach out to Him, He will reach into you. He's never far from any of us. Call upon Him and He will answer you. May this Christmas be a reminder that you are not alone. No matter what you face, no matter how your life might look so uncertain, probably you've gone through a broken marriage, you've gone through a death in your home, but may this good news of Christmas remind you His name is Emmanuel. God is with us. Listen to Rebecca sing this song. Done four songs this far, and I'm sure some of them you knew and you sang along with us from wherever you watched us, friends. Right now, we're going to have a message spoken to you, and my husband Rampert is going to speak to you. It's a joy as a family to come before you and to share this good news of Christmas. It's about the birth of Christ, who has the power to transform our lives and give the hope, the peace, the joy that you're seeking for. He did it for all of us, and He'll surely do it for you. He is Emmanuel.
We've come to the end of the program, and I want to share with you some thoughts from the Word of God. The last song that Rebecca sang talked about pain that we experience in this world. I want to read to you a verse from a song written by Gloria Gaither. It goes this way: "It's not home where men sell their souls and the taste of power is sweet, where wrong is right and neighbors fight while the hungry are dying in the streets, where kids are abused and women are used and the weak are crushed by the strong. Nations gone mad. Jesus is sad. I don't belong." There is a longing in all of us for a better world where there is no sin, no sorrow, no pain. There is also a great longing for true love. I want to read to you two lines from a song that I heard many decades back, maybe 40 years ago. It goes this way: "And I could easily fall from grace, and another can take my place. Then our earthly love seems so fickle, and it seems to this person that you can lose it any time. True love is hard to find." The third thing is, there is a longing for the forgiveness of sins. A friend of ours was traveling in a train where sitting opposite him was a high court judge. He had finished a whole pilgrimage of all the places where he could go to ask for forgiveness of sins. He was going back home, and when our person known to us asked this gentleman, "Did you receive the forgiveness of sin?" That high court judge said, "No." And our friend started to tell him about the Lord Jesus Christ, and he said how the Lord Jesus can forgive sins. And he asked that high court judge, "Would you like to receive this forgiveness?" And right there in the compartment, they knelt down, and the high court judge asked the Lord Jesus to forgive him, to cleanse him, and to make him a new person. And they got up. And as they got up, there was so much of joy in the judge's face. And our friend asked the judge, "Sir, have you received forgiveness now?" He said, "Yes." And at the time, some young people in the compartment were laughing at what was going on. He turned to them and he said, "Fools, you do not know what this means to me." Probably you're sitting there saying, "I wish this world was a better place. I wish I could find true love. I wish I could find forgiveness of sins." That is the purpose for which the Lord Jesus came. He came so that through His birth, death, and His work on the cross, He could offer forgiveness to you. Would you reach out to Him? Because there is no other name under the heaven whereby people can be saved except through Jesus. Because His name says, He shall save His people from their sins. Shall we pray? Dear God, I want to pray for each heart that has been listening to this program. Lord, there are people with deep longings, deep hurts, and a deep need to be forgiven. I pray as they reach out to You and call out to You and say, "Jesus, You came to forgive our sins. Forgive my sins. Make me Your child. Teach me Your ways." I pray that this Christmas You would be born in their hearts and that You would set them free from their sins. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. We wish you all a blessed Christmas and a very happy New Year.